Hello, and welcome to another RangaruCast with me, Rangaroo. And today we are doing a 1v1 on Battle Site Zero. So, on the bottom side, in the blue, playing as Chimera, we got the Commissar. And at the top right, in the red, playing as United States of America, we have ourselves Let's Rock, and that's a very fitting name for a US player. So, as usual, let's speed up another game and see what the initial buildings are going to be. Commissar going for one oil and a Rax. Rolex Rock is going for two oil, but it's pretty much going to be the same effect because this guy is most likely going to be doing double extractor. And that is the case. And he's also going one aluminum. Rolex Rock's going to be capping his bank real fast with some marines. And Commissar doing the same thing, and after getting another oil refinery and an aluminum at the same time. Let's just speed this up a wee bit more, get out of the boring early game, and have to get to the meat of the match. Commissar's taking a little bit of time, bit of money issues getting that aluminum out. And Let's Rock already sending his infantry to the top left bank. And Commissar also doing the same thing, but Let's Rock is definitely going to get there first. Even though it's quite an even amount of warp time between both bases. That's sort of the interesting thing about this map, is that both these banks are fairly up to grabs for both sides, because they're depending on, you know, the starting location, it takes as much time to walk from here to here, from here to here, and vice versa with this bank. So really, it's up for grabs. But oh look, Commissar massing his phalange. And he's going to be assaulting the bank. And I think he is going to take it, because he does have more standard infantry, and looks like he has two marines in here. And the Commissar does take it without any casualties. See, not that much damage lost. Well, that truck is going to be moving up his recon Humvee to do a little bit of damage. Does it have the grenade launcher? No, it's only has a 50 cal. Getting a little bit too close. Taking a few scratches. And the Commissar has already captured the bottom right bank. Let's see, Let's Rock has got himself a logistical bay. Does he have a light vehicle bay? No, he does not. Sticking with a rather infantry heavy. Oh, no, yes, he does. Yes, he does. I do apologize. Getting himself a strikers and as well an armory. Getting a lot of buildings quickly. While the Commissar is building his spear vehicle bay. And he also has a prison for a bit of extra money. And also a support vehicle bay at the same time, so a little bit of column A. Oh, an outpost, I apologise. I keep messing up the building silhouettes, I deeply do apologise about that. Let's speed this up a bit. Let's Rock just getting his strikers out. And an awful lot of them he's salvaging. And the Commissar, what is he going to be building? Not building any Pumas yet. He's got himself a support vehicle bay. That is definitely a support vehicle bay. He's got himself a Puma upgrade and a bunch of Pumas. And Let's Rock has already sent out his strikers. A good five of them. And he's going to be going around the bottom alley. And this will be a great way to attack the enemy. Commissar is mainly focusing on buying buildings, so he won't have too much to defend himself. The Crusters do have machine guns, so they're going to be helping out in this sort of base defense. And oh look, the Striker's actually going down the middle path this time. Just signed in to change it up on me a wee bit. See him get to the destination a little bit faster. No, not as even going for the base, going straight for the bank. Oh, he's checking the refinery, see if there's any up here. Yeah, he did shoot something. And he did shoot the recon UGV. So now the commissar knows that some strikers are up in his bees racks. And I guess he's checking other outer areas of the map for any other refineries. But the commissar has not exactly expanded much. So there's nothing to really kill. The commissar has already built himself a nice little Puma force. And he already has some exo soldiers out and a ninja. And now this ninja, if I guess correctly, he's just going to plant himself in the American base. And because America doesn't really get all that many stealth detection units early on, he can just sit here and enjoy the view. And what a view it is. Let's Rock just pretty much pumping all his money onto getting lots of strikes out. Has four Hercules. He is definitely going for quite a heavy, yeah, two player light vehicle base as well. He's on DEFCON 2 though, because he does have the blazers. And the commissar is going to be seeing this very scary strike force. And he has a force of his own. He has a few Pumas. They don't have the AT missile upgrade, but they do have infantry inside of him. And good infantry, yeah, they got exo soldiers. That's the felons, yes, there's an exo soldier. Now, what is he going to be trying and doing? I'm guessing he's going to try and attack the enemy base. I'd want to assume that his felons do have the capture enemy base upgrade. And he might do a bit of harassment that way. He's moving out just in time, because Let's Rock is just leaving, and he should see his refineries getting attacked into a U-turn. There he says conga line in it in between the buildings. And Let's Rock is definitely going to lose that refinery. But he just does not care. He's beelining straight to the enemy base. I'm thinking that he knows that he has such a big force that, you know, he can't possibly survive. But commissar's already I want to build up a bit of a defense. Already got some sentinel turrets out. Quite a lot of sentinel turrets, yeah. And already some Pumas and exo soldiers of his own. And the exo soldiers already have the healing upgrade. So our Electroc is going for rather heavy unit approach. Commissar's going mainly for the vehicles. Now he does have some action going on over here. Commissar taking all the banks on the map now. And this is, yeah, his ninja's still here, so you can still see everything that's being built. Let's Rock is building a phalanx, so his ninja probably won't survive for all that long. And here comes the strikers. Sentinel turrets. They're giving fire, same with the Echo Soldiers and Pumas. Now the problem is that the strikers are coming in first, and the Hercules are all the way back here, so they're not going to be giving any support right now. And that's all the problem when moving up your units through roads, is that you sort of have to, if you're going to attack an enemy base, click it before the enemy base so they all group up and then attack move. But the strikers already just getting right in there. Already taking a few losses. They do have the Tuscan upgrade, which is bloody huge, double HP and extra DPS. The Hercules now in the fray, yeah, keeping the tanks alive. And Let's Rock doing a bit of damage. He really needs to focus down on sentinel turrets first, and maybe a light vehicle bay. Yeah, two light vehicle bays to worry about. The Hercules doing a fantastic job being the healers. The sentinel turrets taking quite a fraction. Exo soldiers constantly being pumped out the racks. And Let's Rock is moving out a bit, trying to get range. He really just needs to focus fire on buildings. He is focused fire on the research lab. It shouldn't be his main priority. I see his units are kind of shooting everywhere. Hercules doing a great job keeping his last four strikers alive, as you can see. I mean, four Hercules like this is just a chain lock of healing. And the commissar's force is going to be moving back after soldiering the enemy base. And he does have the bank still under his control. And Electroc already building up his forces once again. Let's take a look back over here. So like you're still keeping it strong. Awesome, Commissar, to sell some buildings. At this point, he doesn't really have the firepower to take out any buildings there. He's starting to get shot out from Puma ATGMs. So his best bet is just go for the crushers, go for the easy kills. He's trying to get range on the Pumas. And this has been quite a long base or so. Must have been very, very taxing on the Commissar, seeing all those units just come right into your base and start blowing everything up. But he's doing a very good job containing it. It would have been probably slightly better to try and focus fire on the Hercules first. Because the Hercules is the heart of most US armored forces. This is going to fall out, drop to retreat. With his few units left alive. But he did do quite a bit of damage, killing a lot of crushers, killing some buildings down here, and some sentinel turrets. And just look at the destruction. All those craters and wrecks and rubble. Now Electro Cord expanded a little bit on the left hand side. And he is just pumping out the strikers once again. And he didn't really get two Hercules out, which is a good save. Yeah, the Commissar is definitely bringing in a lot of money. He has four banks under his control. Let's take a look at the player's economy. Is the Commissar got none? Probably spent a lot of his money rebuilding his base and buying lots of Pumas and getting some money from just capturing some chaps. Or let's rock. Yeah, he has full on aluminum. Which is definitely rightfully so. He's sticking with a striker force, which is mostly a mostly an oil force. Yeah, two snipers clearing out the bank.
Unit
and let's rock already moving out again. Right now, it's still pretty even Stevens. I mean, the Commissar's already expanded a wee bit. Still has an economy going on. He still has quite a lot of banks, but Let's Rock already initiating an engagement and doing a lot of damage in the Commissar's main base. So the Commissar's already started to gain back a force. He has a bunch of Pumas this time, fully upgraded. The AT missiles are definitely going to be a very useful asset to have. Both sides deciding to stick with this light vehicle piss. Or light vehicle aggression. And the Pumas are a very nice one to go with as Chimera if you really take advantage of the infantry carrying capability. Because a Puma loaded off with Exo Soldiers is a very scary force to deal with. And the Pumas are going to be moving up once again through the top hill. Probably going to hit this refinery. And this FOB, which is going to get built. At the same time, Letrog moving around the bottom side. And he is going to be doing a bit of damage. The Exo Soldier's already spotting him. Puma's already engaging the refinery up top. And once again, we've got the same situation. Both sides attacking each other's base, but not having a force here to defend it. Which is definitely a gimmick of this map, because the map's so big and there's so many pathways to enemy bases. Both big forces usually miss each other, and most of the battles happens in the enemy base and enemy refineries. And the Commissar's already assaulting the bank of crap tons of exos, and that should be enough to clear it out. And this time Letrock deciding to fall back and defend his base this time. Commissar does take the bank. And Electro's nothing in the base for real defense. Has a phalanx turret, but that's really it. There's Boomers that's attacking the refineries, but yes, at this time in the game, home base refineries are a worthless thing to shoot at because they're completely empty and they hold no strategic purpose to the enemy. You're pretty much just doing them a favor by killing it. And that's going to give Letrock some time to come back and protect the valuable assets. And he is going to DEFCON run. Just needs a slight more aluminum. Attacking the home base of the estate, not going to be getting any resource kills, because most of the resources are going to be in the other corners of the map. It does seem like Let's Rock, he only had this one refinery up here, doesn't really have anything anywhere else. I mean, this one got just destroyed. He's building the Luminin down here. And here we go, we got the engagement on the Strikers, they're going to get right close, and their cannons will be enough to deal with the Pumas. There's the Pumas, you want to stay at range.
Stealth enemy unit detected.
The Commissar still pumping out, just well, Pumas once again. Neither side, you know, fine to go for a heavy tank, because a heavy tank, you know, either the Terminator or Abrams from either side would really throw a ballpark. Well, not a ballpark, would really throw a ball. I forgot, I don't know the bloody phrase. Really throw a wrench into the enemy team's plan. Because these forces are pretty good for dealing with, you know, other light armored forces. But when the heavy tanks start rolling in, they become a little bit pants. Now, look, Let's Rock is going for lots of javelins, and javelins are always a fantastic unit in any US deck. Those ATGM missiles are rather scary, especially with the upgrade. And look, Commissar is already moving up with Pumas. Getting the ATGMs off, the Hercules are slowly behind, so the Strikers getting right in there. And once you see the Strikers get in, they just eat up the Pumas. And that's the thing with Pumas, even though they're kind of nice to get by themselves, you do need something in front of them, whether it's Exo-Soldiers or Terminators or other units, to keep them alive, because they cannot stay alive for the life of them. Now, we just have javelins pounding at the bank. That's going to force the Exos to actually leave and just go right in there and start attacking. And yeah, these guys are going to do all out well against a heavily armored infantry dude. The Shredder moving up, getting destroyed.
Stealth enemy unit detected.
And here's the sniper, finally to do some proper damage. And yeah, both sides are really vying for lots of light vehicles. They are really focused on this run strategy. Oh look, we got a helipad coming out from the Commissar. Some Tigris would definitely be a nice sort of game changer. You've got some Strikers doing some long range bombardment. And the bank is now clear. Now Let's Rock gonna be moving up, but it's not gonna work. Not against just as many Pumas.
Stealth enemy unit detected.
Not a chance. I know, look, Let's Rock now falling back. Not wanting to attack. Just wanting to clear its bank, I guess, which only has one Exo Soldier in there. All it needs is just one sniper to clear him out. And does either side even have a super weapon? Or maybe super weapons are off. Oh, he didn't even have the captor training. No, now he has the Commissar, that is. Let's just speed this up a bit more. Here you see, you got Strikers engaging processing plant. Here we go. Yeah, the Pumas are just gonna eat up the outforce.
Stealth enemy unit detected.
And Let's Rock just starting to get to smaller forces now. I don't think he really has the economy to get a big force anymore. Well, the Commissar just has this mass of Pumas. But neither side are wanting to attack. I think if the Commissar were to attack, he'd probably win the match now. No, look, Let's Rock getting a heavy vehicle bay. Probably going to be seeing some Abrams being rolled out. That'll be a fantastic counter to the Pumas. Now he's just getting end losses. Long range artillery pieces, also another good unit for harassing enemy bases. Tigra is doing some damage over here, and they do have The AA and anti-tank missile upgrades. So already a scary force. No mass-mounted sideshow. And is that? Oh, look, we got a nuke or an Amiga cannon. And there's no Patriot missile system. And this is gonna do a bit of damage. And here it comes. Not exactly as cool as the nuke, but it's kind of like drawing a big balls around the enemy base. It did do quite a bit of damage. Blowing up racks. Hitting a phalanx and doing quite a bit of HP damage to the HQ itself. And destroying the logistical bay. So a good hit, I'd have to admit. Another one of those would definitely rename the game. But I think he's already run. He's just such a big force. Just not deciding to attack yet. We've got Tigris Hill for air, clean everything up. It's not just a matter of time. Yeah, here comes the last run. The Amiga cannon to end it all. Yeah, this is going to be a GG to come, so. It just goes around, blows everything up. Electrorg not surrendering. Wanting to stay in this match. And yeah, Electrorg does surrender, and that will be a good game. Commissar taking a victory in a rather interesting match from both sides. Really vying for that light vehicle play. Electrorg had a fantastic early game initiative with all those strikers, but he didn't really build up his economy all that much. And in a later game, he just couldn't keep up a big force for the Commissar. You know, didn't spend as much on his army or much on his unit early game, but once he got to the mid and late game, and he started to go out really big, scary force, get the Amiga cannons, and just attack. But yeah, he was a little bit defensive on both sides, but a good match nonetheless. And round that's all I have time for. This has been another Rangrocast. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. And as usual, please just take it easy.